You most likely have encountered prints with some spots looking matte and some having a gloss shine. The main reason why this defect appears is that the filament spends way more time in the hot end than printing small features and way shorter time during fast continuous moves. This is where the variable temperature control comes into play. It automatically lowers the hot end's temperature for slow sections to prevent overcooking and overextruding the filament, while increasing the temperature for the fast sections to give an extra boost. So let's find out more about this game-changing printing feature after a quick message from today's video sponsor, PCBWay. If you're looking for professional services for your projects like CNC machining, 3D printing from metal or PCB manufacturing, make sure to check PCBWay with a link in the video description and get multiple discount coupons during their current 10th anniversary sale. It is quite obvious that the faster the filament travels through the hot end, the less time it has to heat up. This means that with different printing speeds, our filaments won't be heated equally, resulting in sections of a print looking more matte and over shinier. If we take a closer look at a test piece that was printed at slow versus fast speeds, we can easily see all the microfracturing happening in the fast section due to the filament not being heated fully. This is exactly why we get those matte areas in the prints. To combat this problem, many people just crank the hot end's temperature and call it a day. I never liked this approach because if a model has sections with small features, we will print them way slower even on fast coarse Y machines and overcook the filament. That not only can lead to a lower layer adhesion, but also can produce way more nasty emissions. This is where the variable temperature for the printing comes in. It is a post-processing G-code script made by Salim for slick Freya-based slicers and clipper 3D printers. It modifies the G-code and sets the temperature depending on the extrusion flow rate and adjusts the printing speed to gradually increase or decrease with the temperature. I was made aware of a script by the creator a couple of weeks ago and I have been testing it for around a week. I was truly excited to test as I wanted something like this for a while, and I'm happy to say that the more I tested, the more I liked what I saw. With some experience you can get up to really good results. So let's go over the main basics when using the script and then compare the test prints that were printed with the fixed temperature versus the variable one. So first we download the script to our PC from GitHub, unzip the files and place them in a more permanent location. I just place them on a D drive. Then we copy the IP address of our clipper 3D printer and paste it into the script. This will create a config file of your 3D printer with the required settings to run it. Next, we make sure we're using the print start macro as shown in the instructions. For now, I suggest only using 3D printers that have a stock clipper version and you know how to fully customize the starting G-code commands. This might change in the future, so make sure to also check the official guide. Then we open the Orca slicer and paste these lines into the post-processing script section. Of course, don't forget to adjust the location of the script paths if you place files in the different location. Finally, turn off the arc fitting option as currently the script doesn't support arc moves and make sure you set the speeds to maximum that still gives reliable extrusion. As the script is constantly evolving, these steps can change in the future, so make sure to double check with the official instructions. Now after we hit upload, the post-processing script will pop up and we can play and configure stuff to our liking. You'll have to play with temperatures, flow rates and pressure advance values on your own as it will depend on your printer's capabilities and the filament. On the right side we have how fast your hot end can heat up and cool down. You should time how long it takes to do that with your specific hot end as you want realistic values for the best results. To further tune the temperature curve there are two main settings, the smoothing of the curve and the speed quality slider. The recommended smoothing value is around 20, you don't want the temperature curve to look too smooth as it will smooth out sections where it dips or rises, but you also don't want it to be too jaggy. Finally, the speed quality slider. To put it as simple as possible, what it does is adjust the temperature curve to either be more dependent on the average flow or more on the max flow. I usually have set it more to speed, but again, play with it and see what works best for your setup. So with basics out of the way, let's look at some test print comparisons. First, I printed the 3D Benchy and used Panda Revo hot end with a high flow brass nozzle. This model is probably the worst case scenario for the true potential for the script as we have rapidly changing flow rates and it is not realistic to change the hot end's temperature in such short time. I checked both prints for differences, but it was so hard to find any. The only things I spotted were the overall consistency of the surface shine when using the variable temperature and the top section maintained its shape better because it was printed at a lower temperature. At this point I realized that this high flow CHT type nozzle might be too high flow to show the difference better, so I changed it to the regular Revo nozzle. I played more with settings and tried printing the same boat using the black color filament. Again, both prints looked quite similar, but now the surface shine consistency was way more pronounced. The print with a fixed temperature had a hard transition from shiny to a more matte finish compared to the print with a variable temperature. This result made me optimistic about the next print, as it should benefit significantly more from the variable temperature control. It might be difficult to see it on camera, but the legs, head and the tail of a cat looked less shiny and more in line with the middle section. Meanwhile, using the fixed temperature, the print had a way more noticeable difference. Inspired by these results, I designed something that would truly showcase the optimal use case scenario. This basic practical print represents it very well because it includes low sections that would benefit from a lower printing temperature and high speed sections that could take advantage of a temperature boost. But the real question is, does it actually work? Yes, the print with fixed temperature showed signs of filling extrusion and the segments printed at low flow rates looked severely overcooked. While the print with a variable temperature wasn't perfect, it had a significant lower variation in the surface shine. Considering that all these results were achieved just by quickly playing with the settings, I wanted to see how the surface changes depending on the flow rates and make the final proper test print where I take that into account. So I designed another practical print and hope for the best. The difference was clear from the start. The print with a fixed temperature had a noticeable surface shine on the pillars, while the one with a variable temperature looked nearly flawless. Checking the prints closer with a lighting that shows defects better on camera made me appreciate the results even more. The difference is significant, and I hope variable temperature control will be the next step in 3D printing. The only things that you should take into account are the hot end's thermal mass and the print times. The smaller the hot end, the quicker it can heat up and cool down, so something like this, Panda Revo or bamboo type hot ends would probably be the best. Given how effectively genuine CHT type nozzles and hot ends heat the filaments at higher speeds with higher temperatures, these would be perfect for the variable temperature printing. Finally, the print times. Because the script must transition between different hot end temperatures, it also alters the speed. And add some time to the prints. But those are nothing major, considering the quality improvements we get. If you're interested, check out the GitHub for this project and try it yourself. The script is constantly evolving, so things might change with more features and improvements. Huge thanks to all the Patreon and YouTube members for your continued support. Well, that's all from me, and we'll see you next time.